And here we are back once again, my friends. Welcome. My name is Tommy. I am lazy and not wanting to hook up my webcam at this time. Welcome back. I'm home now from my Labor Day vacation, and I've come back to see that one of my favorite races has returned in style and in full as a player race in Pathfinder 2nd Edition. And we've got it right here for you today. Let's talk about the next uncommon ancestry of the Lost Omens character guide, the Leshy. If you're liking what you're seeing, remember, friends, like and subscribe and ding the bell. Stay caught up with all your Pathfinder 1st and 2nd Edition content today. Actually, really quickly, in spite of the fact that I have like a boatload of new high tier patrons, today of all days, this episode of your Pathfinder 2nd Edition content was brought to you in part by each and every one of the Black Dragon Disciples, BDG's patrons. In between working part-time at a Chipotle and full-time at YouTube, my work schedule is really, really full right now. And I just want to say that I am incredibly grateful to all the men and women out there that will still support my dream of playing the game we love, bringing you that sweet content, whilst also understanding that sometimes there's a three-day weekend, and when all your partners are off over that three-day weekend, well, sometimes you just gotta get away from it. In spite of that, without you guys, that would not be possible. So thank you for your patience, your support, your friendships, your memes on my Discord, all of the above. You guys are great. And also, quick shout out to labor unions. If anybody's out there who might be a part of them, it might not be the exact time of the year to say 8 hours for work, 8 hours for sleep, 8 hours for what we will. But it's hard to go and celebrate a holiday like Labor Day without thanking the people who kicked it up in the first place. Anyway, soapbox done. Let's talk about the Vine Leshy. And I just said Vine Leshy, I'm gonna leave it in there. There's a fun typo for you guys, because that was, in fact, the player race in Pathfinder 1st Edition as of Ultimate Wilderness that saw these guys go from special familiars for druids and, like, some other things with shenanigans to a true race. Never have I ever played one. I did theorycraft one as a backup Rune Lords character. But I did have a druid with a Gord Leshy companion named Oleg, and Oleg was kind of, both in terms of in the game we were playing, being based on an N64 game, real powerful, but also kind of the party's mascot. I still don't exactly know what it means when my player flavored his little buddy is talking in Studio Ghibli noises. Nevertheless, that's definitely what we're looking at here. And in 2nd Edition, it's not just the Vine Leshy, it's literally all of them. This is almost as big as saying, like, the fairy dragon or the imp or something like that had become a player race. And I suppose that does kind of open the door up, fingers crossed. Anyway, for a little bit of lore, in case you hadn't picked up on the Vine Leshy video from 1E, I would tell you to follow this card right up here, but actually, and maybe this is because I'm just really proud of this, but if you Google Vine Leshy Pathfinder, our video is like the number two result in images, and I'm super stoked about that. But regardless, quote, Leshies are a combination of the physical and the supernatural. The true heart of a Leshy is a nature spirit, but the spirits don't have bodies and can't easily affect the material world on their own. It's only when a master of primal magic, now when we say it that way, one wonders if that's mechanical now, creates a suitable vessel for a spirit and a spirit accepts that vessel as a body, that a Leshy is born. Once a Leshy is created, they could theoretically live forever, though the dangers of Galarian mean this rarely occurs. And Leshy souls don't go to the boneyard upon death. Instead, they go back into nature and could even be summoned as another Leshy with those memories intact. Now, like we talked about with the Hobgoblins of 2E, the Leshy is in fact an uncommon ancestry. That is to say, they may not fit every campaign, and that makes sense for the guys that live in the forest and may not travel very far beyond their homes. The Leshy gets 8 hit points from its ancestry, is a small creature with a speed of 25 feet. Again, I think that's basically par for the course. They speak Common and of course Sylvan, and mechanically have the same ability boosts and flaws of the Vine Leshy of Pathfinder 1st Edition, with the exception of that freebie, of course. That is to say, a boost to Constitution and Wisdom with a flaw in Intelligence. And to be honest, that might be looking like one of the best races mechanically based on ability score adjustments alone in 2nd Edition. I love the Halfling. I love Lucky Halfling, but that Strength neg hurts in a world with bulk, whereas an Int neg doesn't really hurt a lot of things. And also, they don't eat like most PCs do, rather using good old photosynthesis, or rotting matter in the case of, like, your fungus fleshies, though they have discovered a way to bottle nutrients in case you need to, like, go into the Darklands or something. Last thing we have to talk about with these guys today is the seed pod feat for the leshies. In case you really, really just wanted to play that Deku Scrub, maybe not that much of a terrible fate after all. Level 1 feat, you gain a seed pod ranged unarmed attack that deals 1d4 bludgeoning damage. These strikes have the manipulate trait. On a critical hit, a seed pod bursts, issuing forth a tangle of vegetation that imposes a -10-foot circumstance penalty on a target's speed for a round. Seed pods do not add critical specialization effects, but if those are unarmed attacks, I guess we can flurry with them. Pew 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 for profit, a la the monk, you say? Yeah, sure, why not? I'll take it. In any case, this is definitely an ancestry I'm looking forward to see pan out as the game goes. They're adorable, they were one of my favorites. You guys know I'm a very hashtag green faith kind of man. I've said it a billion times, and I'm super stoked to see, once the Lost Omens character guide drops, how these guys are going to pan out. I suppose by default that means the Eruxi is next week, huh? Fair enough, sounds good. In any case, what do you guys think? Are we happy to see the Leshy come down? Will we be playing Leshies in games? How does this work for our Leaf Druids getting Leshy familiars? What's the distinction exactly? I now have a confusion. Does this mean I can be someone's familiar? Neato! Anyway, thank y'all for watching. We'll see you next time.